Welcome, Barack Obama. Please welcome Barack Obama.
Hello, Greece. Kalispera.
Kalispera. Γεια σας.
To the government and the people of Greece, including Prime Minister Tsipras, who I thank for his partnership and for being here, along with so many young people, the future of Greece, I want to thank you for your warm and generous welcome. As many of you know, this is my final trip overseas as President of the United States. And I was determined on my last trip to come to Greece, partly because I've heard about the legendary hospitality of the Greek people, your philoxenia. Partly because I had to see the Acropolis and the Parthenon, but also because I came here with gratitude for all that Greece, this small great world, has given to humanity through the ages. We are indebted to Greece for the most precious of gifts, the truth, the understanding that as people of free will, we have the right and the capacity to govern ourselves. For it was here, 25 centuries ago, in the rocky hills of this city, that a new idea emerged. Demokratia, kratos, the power, the right to rule, comes from demos, the people. The notion that we are citizens, not servants, but stewards of our society. The concept of citizenship, that we have both rights and responsibilities, the belief in equality before the law, not just for the few, but for the many, not just for the majority, but also for the minority. These are all concepts that grew out of this rocky soil. Through the history, the flame that first lit here in Athens never died. It was ultimately nurtured by a great enlightenment. It was fanned by America's founders, who declared that we, the people, shall rule. That all men are created equal and endowed by our Creator with certain inalienable rights. Now, at times, even today, those ideals are challenged. We've been told that these are Western ideals. We've been told that some cultures are not equipped for democratic governance and actually prefer other rule. And I will say that after 8 years of being president of the United States, having traveled around the globe, it is absolutely true that every country travels its own path. Every country has its own traditions. But what I also believe, after 8 years, is that the basic longing to live with dignity, the fundamental desire to have control of our lives and our future, and to want to be part of determining the course of our communities and our nations, these things are universal. They burn in every human heart. That's how, just as democracies are premised on the peaceful resolution of disagreements within our societies, we also believe that cooperation and dialogue is the best way to address challenges between nations. And so it is my belief that democracies are more likely to try to resolve conflicts between nations in a way that does not result in war. 25 centuries after Athens first pointed the way, 250 years after the beginning of the great American journey, my faith, my confidence, my certainty in our democratic ideals and universal rules remain undiminished. I believe more strongly than ever that Dr. King was right when he said that the arc of moral universe is long, but it bends towards justice. But it bends towards justice not because it is inevitable, but because we bend it towards justice. Not because there are not going to be barriers to achieving justice, but because there will be people, generation after generation, who have the vision and the courage and the will to bend the arc of our lives in the direction of a better future. In the United States and in every place I have visited these last 8 years, I've met citizens, especially young people, who have chosen hope over fear, who believe that they can shape their own destiny, who refuse to accept the world as it is and are determined to make it as it should be. They have inspired me. In every corner of the world, I have met people who, in their daily lives, demonstrate that despite differences of race or religion or creed or color, we have the capacity to see each other in ourselves. We live under the same sun. We fall in love under the same moon. We are all human. We have to help these people. This was said by a woman here in Greece who said that to the refugees arriving on these shores. Women like that give me hope. In all of our communities, in all of our countries, I still believe there is more of what Greeks call philotimo, love and respect and kindness for family and community and country, and a sense that we're in all this together with obligations to each other. Philotimo, I see every day, and that gives me hope, because in the end, it is up to us. It's not somebody else's job. It's not somebody else's responsibility, but it is the citizens of our countries and citizens of the world to bend that arc of history towards justice. And that's what democracy allows us to do. That's why the most important office in any country is not president or prime minister. The most important title is citizen. And in all of our nations, it will always be our citizens who decide the kind of countries we will be, the ideals that we will reach, and the values that will define us. In this great, imperfect, but necessary system of self-government, power and progress will always come from the demos, from we, the people. And I'm confident that as long as we are true to that system of self-government, that our futures will be bright. Thank you very much.